In this video, I'm going to show you how to apply horizontal filter in Excel, and we're going to use a smart function for that. So make sure to watch and let's get started. All right, so here you can see I have this data. Here I have just two rows. This data is basically a horizontal data from cell A1 to cell A02. That means two rows from column A to column A02. Now the point is I want to apply horizontal filter, and the problem is in Excel there is no default option to apply a horizontal filter, but you can use a smart function that is called filter to apply a horizontal filter. Now let me enter this function called filter. It's a new function and quite smart. So in the first argument, that is array, I'm going to select the entire data from cell A1 to A02. Now in the second argument, which is include, I need to select the row from where I want to apply the condition. So I'll go and select this age row, and with the age row, I'm going to specify a condition that condition is to filter data where the age is either equal to 40 or above 40. That means greater than, equal, and then 40. In the third argument, I'm going to specify nothing, because if there is no value according to this condition, I need a blank result. Let me close the function and hit enter. So you can see I have all the values where age is above 40. And now let me change this criteria from 40 to 45 and let me hit enter. And here I have three names where the age is above 45. Now let me make it more dynamic. I'll connect this formula with the cell so that we can apply filter using a dynamic way. So I'll select cell A4 and hit enter. And now let me add value here, let's say 45. So it will apply filter for all the cells where the age is above or equal to 45. Now let's make this horizontal filter a little more realistic. Let's say if you want to filter data where name starts with S. For this, we're going to write a condition, and again, I'm going to use the filter function. So I'll enter the filter function, select the data, but this time I will not select the row headings. I'll start from the cell B1 and then up to the last cell. Now in the include argument, which is the second argument, I will use one more function, that is left function, to extract the first alphabet of the name. So I'll specify the first row where I have the names, and along with the characters, because I just want the first character, so I'm going to specify 1. Now the condition is if the first character of the name is equal to S, and again blank for no values. If there is no value, then blank. And now I'm going to hit enter to see what I'm going to get in return. So you can see I have two names. One is Stacy and the second is Shimar, and I have age as well for both of the names. Now what I'll do, I'll move this formula a little lower, and I will also add the row headings. And now let me move it. Yes, that's it. So I'm going to connect this formula to a cell so that we can filter data. So instead of hard coding this S in the formula, I'm going to connect it with the cell A5 and hit enter. So if I specify S, I get all the names that starts with S. And if I say I want to go with B, I get names that starts with the alphabet D.
Hey, thanks for watching this video, and you can download your free ebook that I have promised from the link in the description. And make sure to subscribe to the channel, because I'll be coming out with a lot of cool Excel tips and tricks in coming weeks. So make sure to subscribe and like this video.